శుక్లాంబరధరం విష్ణుం శశివర్ణం చతుర్భుజం ప్రసన్నవదనం ధ్యాయేత్ సర్వవిఘ్నోపశాంతయే రామాయ రామభద్రాయ రామచంద్రాయ వేధసే రఘునాథాయ నాథాయ సీతాయ పతయే నమః. ఓం. డియర్ ఫ్రెండ్స్, వీ ఆర్ సీయింగ్ ద వాల్మీకి రామాయణ. వీ ఆర్ ఇన్ దిస్ అయోధ్యకాండ. వీ ఆర్ జస్ట్ సీయింగ్ హౌ దశరథ డిసైడ్స్ టు సే ఇన్స్టాల్ రామ యాజ్ ద ప్రిన్స్ రీజెంట్, దట్ ఈస్ యువరాజ. సో హీ హ్యాస్ టు సే ఇన్స్టాల్ హిమ్ అండ్ దెన్ హీ హ్యాస్ ఇన్స్ట్రక్టెడ్ హిమ్ టు డూ దట్ ఉపవాస దీక్ష. అండ్ దెన్ వీ వర్ సీయింగ్ యాక్చువల్లీ యాజ్ టు హౌ రామ వాజ్ డూయింగ్ దట్ ఉపవాస దీక్ష. దట్ ఈస్ వీ వర్ ఇన్ సెక్షన్ సిక్స్, దట్ ఈస్ సర్గ సిక్స్, వేర్ వాల్మీకి ఈజ్ డిస్క్రైబింగ్ యాజ్ టు హౌ రామ వాజ్ అబ్జర్వింగ్ దట్ ఉపవాస. సో దట్ అగైన్ దట్ ఆల్సో ఐ వాజ్ జస్ట్ రీడింగ్ అవుట్ ఎ ఫ్యూ శ్లోకాస్ జస్ట్ టు సీ వాట్ ఎగ్జాక్ట్లీ ఆర్ ది కండిషన్స్, వాట్ వాజ్ ది ఎటికెట్, వాట్ ఆర్ ది ధర్మ విచ్ వాజ్ ఫాలోడ్. సో హీ ఐ వాస్ ఎక్స్ప్లెయినింగ్ టు యూ అబౌట్ వై రామ వాజ్ డూయింగ్ దిస్ వర్షిప్ ఆఫ్ నారాయణ. వై నో దట్ హీ ఈస్ ది అవతార, హీ ఈజ్ నారాయణ హిమ్సెల్ఫ్, దెన్ వై షుడ్ హీ వర్షిప్ నారాయణ. ఐ వాజ్ ఎక్స్ప్లెయినింగ్ టు యూ దట్ దట్ ఇన్ఫినిట్ రియాలిటీ ఆర్ దట్ ఇన్ఫినిట్ సే సుప్రీం గాడ్ హీ ఈజ్ నౌ అపియరింగ్ ఇన్ ఎ ఫైనైట్ షేప్, ఇన్ ఎ విజిబుల్ టాంజిబుల్ షేప్. సో హీ హ్యాస్ టు ఫాలో దిస్ పర్టిక్యులర్ ధర్మ. సో లాంగ్ యాజ్ హీ ఈజ్ ఇన్ ఎ ఫిజికల్ బాడీ, సో హీ హ్యాస్ టు ఫాలో ది ధర్మ. సో దట్ ఈస్ ద రీజన్ వై హీ వాస్ డూయింగ్ దిస్ నారాయణ ఉపాసన, దట్ ఈస్ ద ఉపాధి ధర్మ. దట్ ఈస్ వాట్ ఐ వాజ్ ఎక్స్ప్లెయినింగ్. దెన్ హీ ఆల్సో డిడ్ దిస్ యజ్ఞ, హీ ఆల్సో పర్ఫార్మ్డ్ ఎ స్మాల్ యజ్ఞ. శేషం చ హవిషస్తస్య ప్రాశ్య ఆత్మనఃప్రియం. యు సీ యజ్ఞ శిష్టం, యజ్ఞ శిష్టం మీన్స్ వాట్ ఎవర్ ఈజ్ లెఫ్ట్ ఆఫ్టర్ ది ఆబ్లేషన్స్ ఆర్ ఓవర్. సో వేరియస్ థింగ్స్ ఆర్ గివన్ ఆబ్లేషన్స్ అండ్ దెన్ వేరియస్ పీపుల్ ఆర్ ఆల్సో గివన్ ఫుడ్ అండ్ వాట్ ఎవర్ ఈజ్ లెఫ్ట్ దట్ ఈస్ వాట్ ఈస్ కాల్డ్ యజ్ఞ శిష్టం, వాట్ ఎవర్ ఈజ్ రిమైనింగ్. సో యజ్ఞ శిష్టాశీనస్సంతో ముచ్యంతే సర్వకిల్బిషై సేస్ గీత. దట్ ఈస్ పీపుల్ హూ ఫీడ్ ఆల్ అదర్స్, హూ పర్ఫార్మ్ ది యజ్ఞ ఇన్ ఎ పర్టికులర్ ఇన్ ఎ ప్రాపర్ వే అండ్ ఆఫ్టర్ ఎవ్రీబడి ఈజ్ ఫెడ్ వాట్ ఎవర్ ఈజ్ రిమైనింగ్ ది యజమాని ఈజ్ సపోజ్ టు ఈట్. సో సచ్ పీపుల్ దే గెట్ రీడ్ ఆఫ్ ఆల్ ది కిల్బిష, ఆల్ ది పాపాస్ ఎట్సెట్రా దే ఆర్ గీతా సేస్. సో సంథింగ్ సిమిలర్ వీఆర్ సీయింగ్ హియర్, యజ్ఞ సిస్టమ్. సో హీ టుక్ ఆల్ హీ ఏట్ అండ్ దెన్ హీ మెడిటేటెడ్ ఆన్ నారాయణ అండ్ ఆల్సో అబ్జర్వ్డ్ సైలెన్స్. శ్రీమతి ఆయతనే విష్ణోహో ఆయతనే, దట్ ఈస్ ఇన్ ది సేమ్ ప్లేస్ ఇన్ ద సేమ్ మేబీ ఎ టెంపుల్ లైక్ థింగ్ మేబీ ఇన్ ద సేమ్ ఇన్ హిజ్ ఓన్ హౌస్ ఇన్ వాట్ ఎవర్ ఈజ్ పూజా గృహ ఆర్ వాట్ ఎవర్ ఇట్ ఈస్ ఇన్ దట్ సేమ్ ప్లేస్ ఓన్లీ. శిష్యేన అరవరాత్మజ, దట్ ఈస్ హీ స్లెప్ట్ దేర్ ఓన్లీ అండ్ వెరీ ఎర్లీ ఇన్ ద మార్నింగ్ హీ గాట్ అప్ అండ్ అగైన్ వాల్మీకి డిస్క్రైబ్స్ ఎవ్రీ లిటిల్ ఇన్సిడెంట్. యూ సీ ఐ వాస్ టెలింగ్ యూ వాల్మీకి ఈజ్ వెరీ పర్టికులర్ అబౌట్ ఆల్ ది డీటెయిల్స్. సో హీ డిడ్ దిస్ గాయత్రి జప, హీ డిడ్ దిస్ సంధ్యావందన. పూర్వాం సంధ్యాముపాసీనో జజాప సుసమాహిత. జప, గాయత్రి జపం హీ డిడ్. జప ఈజ్ స్లైట్లీ డిఫరెంట్ ఫ్రమ్ మెడిటేషన్. యు సీ గాయత్రి జప, ఇఫ్ యు ఆర్ ఓన్లీ రిసైటింగ్ ఏ మంత్ర విదౌట్ బాదరింగ్ అబౌట్ ది మీనింగ్ ఇట్ ఈస్ కాల్డ్ జప. సపోజ్ ఐ సే ఓం భూర్భోత్సవ తత్సవితృవరేణ్యం ఎట్సెట్రా ఎట్సెట్రా అండ్ ఆల్సో టర్న్ ది గార్లండ్ ఆఫ్ బీడ్స్. సో దట్ ఈస్ వాట్ ఈస్ జప. మెడిటేషన్ ఈజ్ స్లైట్లీ డిఫరెంట్. మెడిటేషన్ ఈజ్ స్లైట్లీ ఇట్ ఈస్ అ సార్ట్ ఆఫ్ ఇంటలెక్చువల్ యాక్టివిటీ వేర్ యు ఆర్ కాంటెంప్లేటింగ్, యు ఆర్ కాంటెంప్లేటింగ్ అండ్ ఇట్ ఈస్ సంథింగ్ విచ్ ఈస్ అన్ అనాలిసిస్ ఆఫ్ సే వాట్ ఈస్ ఆత్మ విచార యాజ్ వీ కాల్ ఇట్. ఇట్ ఈస్ సంథింగ్ సే వాట్ వీ కాల్ వేదాంత విచార. సో జప, సింపుల్ జప ఈజ్ డిఫరెంట్ ఫ్రమ్ మెడిటేషన్. ఇన్ మెడిటేషన్ దెర్ ఈస్ ఎ సార్ట్ ఆఫ్ అనాలిసిస్, మెడి దిస్ జప ఈజ్ ఎ మెకానికల్ యాక్టివిటీ. అఫ్ కోర్స్ జప ఆల్సో వన్ కెన్ కీప్ ఆన్ మెడిటేటింగ్ ఆన్ ద మీనింగ్ ఆఫ్ దట్ మంత్ర. సో దట్ ఇట్ డిపెండ్స్ ఆన్ వాట్ లెవెల్ ఎ పర్సన్ డస్ దిస్ జప. సో హీ డిడ్ దట్ జప, గాయత్రి జప అండ్ దేర్ ఆఫ్టర్ అండ్ వెన్ హీ కేమ్ అవుట్ ఆల్ ది ఎంటైర్ సిటీ ఆల్ దిస్ పుణ్యాహ వాచనం. పుణ్యాహ వాచనం మీన్స్ ఎవ్రీవేర్ ది పండిట్స్ దేవర్ చాంటింగ్ ఆల్ దిస్ పుణ్యాహం. పుణ్యాహం ఈజ్ అ పర్టిక్యులర్ రిచువల్. Various Vedic mantras are recited saying that, oh, let this day be very holy, let this day be very auspicious. Punya aha. Punya means, say, auspicious. Aha means day. Punya aha means, let this be a glorious day, let this be a very, very auspicious day. Whatever is, say, proposed to be taken place today, let it take place in a very grand manner. So, that sort of wish. So, that is what we see. And we also see that Valmiki even described earlier, flags and banners, they were all erected on all crossroads, shops. We are seeing the next morning, this is the morning situation. On all crossroads, on all shops, on all huge buildings and also on all tall trees, etc., there were all flags and banners. And also Nata Nartaka Sanghanam Gayakanam Cha Gayatam. So Nata Nartaka Sanghan. There were people who were dancers, there were people who were actors, there were people who were singers, all types of people, they were all there, all crowded on the roads. They were all doing that Abhinaya. And everyone, including children, they were all talking about Rama, including all kids. And in fact, anticipating that there would be some sort of procession in the evening. You see, Rama is going to be coronated in the sense he is going to be installed as Yuvaraja. After that, there is likelihood of some procession, and that procession, by the time that procession starts, it may be evening, it may be nightfall. So, anticipating nightfall, they also prepared some lamps. Se deepavrukshan statha chakruhu anurathyasu sarvasha. On the roads everywhere, they also prepared deepavrukshah. Deepavrukshah means lamp posts, maybe some huge pole and various branches, and on every branch there was a lamp or something like that. So they prepared, say, multiple lamps. Nowadays we come across deepastambha, we say like that deepastambha, not one particular deepa, hundreds of deepas, hundreds of lamps around one particular stambha. So that is what is called deepavrukshanastatha chakruhu. Deepastambha is only one stambha, deepavruksha is lot many branches, and then on all those branches there are some lamps. So they prepared, they made such preparations, and they also praised Dasharatha for having taken such a great decision. You see, Aho Mahatma Rajayam Ikshvakukulanandana, this great son of Ikshvaku, this great person, Aho Mahatma, he is a very great man. He has given us a very great king called Rama. And there is another interesting line here. Sarve hyanugruhitasmaha yanno ramo mahipatihi chiraya bhavita gopta drushta lokaparavarah. You see, he is a person, Rama is a person, he knows drushta lokaparavarah. He knows the difference, who has to be treated how. Para means high, avara means low. Drushta paravaraha means he knows who is to be respected, who is high and who is low. He knows the values of the value of the people. He knows the worth of the people and treats, respects them accordingly. And anuddhatamana means he is a person who is totally devoid of any arrogance. Uddhata means if I am holding a position, I show off so much, I show so much of arrogance. So a person who is not having arrogance. Then vidwan, dharmatma, bhratruvatsalah, a person who loves his brothers. And also like the same bhratru, yatha, like he loves his own brothers, he loves all the people. Yatha cha bhratrushu snigdha, tatha asmaswapi. Like he loves his own brothers, he loves all of us. Vatsala. Here a very wonderful word is used here, vatsala. Vatsala is again, vatsa means a child or a calf. Vatsala actually refers to a particular dhenu. Dhenu is a cow which has freshly given birth through a calf. It is called a vatsala. And what happens when a calf is delivered? The calf is delivered with all that the water from the womb, that is placenta and all that. And the child, that calf is somewhere on the earth with all dirt and all that, but still the cow licks the whole body and wakes it up. As soon as the child is born, the calf is born, the cow actually licks the entire body, licks the whole body in spite of all that liquid, dirt and all that, it licks the whole body and wakes it up. And it is only then that the calf gets up. So like that, a person who is able to take care of everybody. You see, bhakta vatsala, we say. What is the meaning of bhakta vatsala? Even if the, a bhakta, even if he is committing some mistakes, the God is so kind to him that he makes these people forget their mistakes. He puts them on the right track. It is not as though he forgets and he forgives all those things. He puts these people on the right path. So, bhakti is supposed to be a sort of self-purifying mechanism. Bhakti is, it is not as though, suppose you go and donate 1 crore rupees to Sri, what is this, Venkatesha. So if you donate 1 crore to Venkatesha anticipating some 100 crore profit, that is not bhakti, it is only a trade, and God also is aware of the trade. But if there is real bhakti, and if there are some doshas, some defects in me, the God will give me some good sense. Dadami buddhi yogam tam, says Gita. Buddhi yogam means I will give him good buddhi, so that he will not go on the wrong track. So bhakti is a sort of purifying mechanism. So that is what we see. And here I was explaining the word Vatsala. So God is somebody, he is also called Bhakta Vatsala. So here Rama is called Vatsala, Bhakta Vatsalaha, Bhratru Vatsalaha, and just as he loves his own brothers, he is going to love, he loves us also. And the people all pray, they all pray, may he live long and may we have a very great king. So that is how they all praise, and that is how this particular sarga has concluded. That is, 6th sarga is over, and now we come to the 7th sarga. In this 7th sarga, we are now going back in time. You see, on the previous day, Dasharatha, he had a conference with all these ministers and all that. And after that closed door conference also, he gave instructions to Rama, observe Upavasa Vratam, etc., etc. He sent him away. And we have seen Rama on one side observing all that Upavasa. And Dasharatha himself, what did he do on that previous night? Giri Guhamiva Simho Giri Guhamiva, like a lion entering the cave, he went into his Antapura. Then what happened? So we are going back in time to see what happened to him on the previous night. So on the previous night, or rather on the previous evening itself, by the time Raja, the King Dasharatha, actually went to the palace, even before that, what had happened on the previous evening, we are now seeing what happened on the previous evening. So Jnati Dasi Yato Jata Kaikeya tu sahoshita, then prasadam chandra sankasham aruroha yadruchaya. There was a jnati dasi, there was a particular servant maid. That particular servant maid, she was somebody who was there right from her birth. She was with Kaikeyi only, or rather right from the birth of Kaikeyi yato jata. You see, you know, in olden days what was happening was, we also saw when Sita came, Janaka sent lot many hundreds of maids and servants and all that. So similarly, Kaikeyi also, she came along with some more her own personal servants. When she got married to Dasharatha, she also came with lot many servants. And one such senior servant is Manthara. This name Manthara also is important, you see. Manthara is somebody who churns the mind. Like Manmatha, Manmatha is Manaha Mathnati, somebody who churns the mind is called Manmatha. So this lady also, the Matha, Matha Dhatu, it means Mathana, Mathanam, Samudra Manthanam, we know, Samudra Manthanam or Mathanam, both one and the same. That is, Manthara is somebody who churns the mind, who spoils the mind. Here, you know, here she is churning the mind of Kaikeyi, she is putting so much of poison, she is giving so many doses of poison to this Kaikeyi. We are going to see that. So, she, what did she do? She went on to her prasadam. Kaikeyi, of course, she is also obviously living in a huge palace. And this servant, she got on to that palace. Yadruchaya. Yadruchaya means by sheer coincidence. By sheer coincidence, she just went on to the top. And then she saw everywhere there is so much of, tumultuous, happiness and joy. People are shouting slogans, and there are flags, banners everywhere, and people are very joyous, and they were also distributing sweets. Malya Modaka Hastaisha, people were carrying garlands, and Modaka, Modaka means sweets, they were distributing sweets. So all these things, the temples were crowded, all the Brahmins were singing, were reciting mantras. So all these things she saw, and she just came across, just then she saw a maid, another maid. Saw Harshotpulla Nayanam, she saw another maid who was so filled with joy, her eyes were filled with joy. So such maid she came across, and she asked, oh, what is going on? What is going on, and what is there any sort of festival which is going on? And she also saw Kaikeyi, Kausalya, giving some gifts to various people. Obviously, from that passage, from that palace, she was able to see what was happening in Kausalya's palace, Kausalya's place also. So what she did was, you see, there is an interesting shloka here. Uttamena abhisanyukta harshena arthaparasati, Ramamata dhanam kimnu janebhyas samprayachati. You see, this Rama Mata, she doesn't take the name of Kausalya. So she has so much of ill will or rather jealousy for Kausalya that she doesn't even utter the name of Kausalya. This Rama Mata, you see, otherwise she is Arthaparasati. Arthapara means somebody who is sticking on to money. Arthaparaha, that is who is just sticking on to money, who is very stingy, who is a tight-fisted, who never gives a rupee to anybody else. So she seems to be doing all, she seems to be giving various gifts to all these people. What is wrong? And she is so extremely happy. Uttamena harshena sanyukta. That is, she is so extremely happy giving so much of money to people. Otherwise a stingy woman. Why is she doing all this? Is there anything? And this other maid servant, she replied, Vidiryamana harshena. The other maid servant, she was just bursting with joy. Vidiryamana, she was just breaking up with joy. She replied, oh, tomorrow Rama is going to be coronated as the prince regent. And the moment Mantara heard it, she became instantly angry. You see, Kshipram Amarshita, Kshipram, Kshipram means immediately, Kshipram Amarshita. She got enraged and she almost ran down the palace steps. She ran down and then went to the bedroom of Kaikeyi. She was just burning with anger. Mantara Papadarshini Sa Dahyamana Krodhena. She was burning in her inside, and Papadarshini was seeing only evil. So she went to Kaikeyi and then she rather speaks harshly. She says, Uttishta Mudhe Kim Sheshe. Oh Mudhe, oh fool, oh foolish woman, oh brainless woman, you are just relaxing. Get up, she says. Bhayam Tvam Abhivartate. You see, you are in a great danger. You are being engulfed in a danger. Upaplutam Amo Aghaughena. You see, you are being drenched, you are being drowned in an ocean of sorrow. So, and you are not realizing. Na Atmanam Avabudhyase. You are not realizing it. And she says, Anishte Subhagakare, she says, the king has definitely cheated you. You are Anishta. Anishta means somebody who is not liked by the king. And Subhagakare, outwardly you appear to be somebody who is being pleased, who is having everything, and then who is a Saubhagyavati. Outwardly you are treated like a Saubhagyavati, but the king is not actually bothered about you. You are Anishta. Saubhagyena Vikathase, you are always boasting about your own Saubhagya. You say that king, we will not cross my word, and then king always listens to me, and then king is in my pocket, something like that. So you say, you are always boasting about your, say, authority over the king. But you see what has happened. Chalam hitava saubhagyam, your fortune is gone. Nadya srotai voshnage, like a thin stream in summer, it gets evaporated. Your fortune also has evaporated like that. So she says. And Kaikeyi doesn't understand. Kaikeyi doesn't understand. Are, what happened? What happened to our, say, kshemam? Abravit kubjam, kachit kshemam namantare. What happened to our kshemam? What is wrong? So she says. And this mantara says, Bhedayanti cha raghavam. So her idea is to generate hatred towards Rama. So that is how she takes it up. She says, now, Akshayam Sumahaddevi Pravurtam Tvad Vinashanam. Your Vinashanam is now coming. And I am also in deep sorrow. Why? Because my fortune depends on your fortune. Tava Dukhena Kaikeyi Mama Dukham Mahad Bhavet. If you are unhappy, I will also be unhappy. Tvad Vruddhav Mama Vruddhishya. If you are, say, in the higher position, I will also be in a higher position. Bhavedihana Samshayaha. Of course, Mantara is worried about her own, future also. You see, if Kaikeyi becomes the queen, then Mantara will be probably the boss of all the maid servants. She will become maid servant general or something like that. So, it is her, idea like that. And she says, Naradhipakule Jata. And now, she wants to work on the mind of Kaikeyi. You see, you are born, you are not from a village, you are not some village girl, some innocent village girl. You are born in the house of a king and you know how royal families behave and you know all the crookedness, all the cruelty which is there in the minds of the kings. She says, Naradhipakule Jata Mahishitvam Mahipatehe. యు ఆర్ బోర్న్ టు ఎ కింగ్ అండ్ యు ఆర్ ద వైఫ్ ఆఫ్ ఎ కింగ్. ఉగ్రత్వం రాజధర్మాణం కథం దేవిన బుద్ధ్యసే. ఉగ్రత్వం, ఆల్ దట్ క్రూయల్టీ ఇన్ మైండ్, వై ఆర్ యు నాట్ ఏబుల్ టు నో? సో యు సీ, కింగ్ మే బి అవుట్వర్డ్లీ అపియరింగ్ వెరీ వెరీ ప్లెజెంట్ అండ్ ఆల్ దాట్, బట్ ఇన్సైడ్ హీ కెన్ బి వెరీ ఉగ్ర. సో దట్ ఈస్ ద రీజన్ వై భర్తృహరి సేస్, వారాంగనేవ నృపనీతి అనేక రీతి. భర్తృహరి సుభాషితాసి సేస్, ఎ కింగ్, యు సీ, హీ లవింగ్లీ షేక్స్ హ్యాండ్స్ విత్ సంబడి, హీ స్మైల్స్ అట్ సంబడి ఎల్స్. Sometimes he is angry, sometimes he is generous, sometimes he is stingy, sometimes he is very very liberal. So like that, varanganeva, that is like a varangana. Varangana means a woman who sells her body for money. So like a varangana, nrupanitihi, behavior of a king, anekaritihi, it changes from time to time. So a king is so unpredictable in his behavior. So that is what she says, you see. Cruel are the ways of the kings. Ugratvam Raja Dharmanam. So he may be outwardly very, very pleasant and doing all namaste. Whenever we see our leaders also, whenever they come, they do all namaste, namaste to everybody. But inwardly, they may be thinking of something else. His mind may be the king's mind, or rather the minister's mind may be on some contract in which he may get 100 crores, or some other way in which he has to crush his opponent, some other way in which he has to take revenge on his enemy. So all these things will be in his mind, but outwardly he will be smiling and then he will be doing all namaste to everybody. So that is that ugratvam. So you are not realizing. Don't you know this dharmavadi shato bharta? Dharmavadi, your bharta, your husband is dharmavadi. Outwardly the fellow is speaking all dharma. Shataha, shata means a very deceitful person. You see how, what word he is using. You see, you see mantara, the very first address of Kaikeyi, shows how much of liberty she is having. You see, in olden days, even the servants, they had a lot of liberty. The long standing servants, suppose they are not a fresh servant who comes for duty today, but somebody who has served you for about 20 years, 30 years. So a family, he is almost a member of the family, but for the fact that he is a servant, he or she. So they have so much of liberty on us, they find fault with us. Sir, you don't know anything, you are doing something foolish. So something like that, Antara is taking liberty with this Kaikeyi and telling. She is saying, you don't know anything, you are born in the royal family. He is a dharmavadi, shataha, shlakshanavadi. Shlakshanavadi means very sweetly he is speaking to you, and shuddha bhave, and you are very plain person. Na janishe, and then you don't know how much he is cheating you. The king is really cheating you, she says. So that is how she is slightly trying to inject poison. We will continue in the next episode. Harihi Om Tat Sat.